Well, a few veggies are still left in Eileen's garden. She started planting in the spring and is harvesting the last of her work. I myself have enjoyed a number of zucchinis over the past season.
Very good. Eileen, you're live to tell us if planting was worth the money and the time and the effort.
Yeah, that's right. A lot of chocolate zucchini bread this year. Yum. In the newsroom. So we're about 40 yards outside of our main studios. That's where Teo and Adrian are, inside of that brick or concrete building there. We planted a studio here, wanted to see if, compared to what you buy at the grocery store, was it worth it to plant a garden during the spring to harvest all summer and fall season? And here's what we came up with. October is here, and so is Pauline Sakai, master gardener from Placer County. We have learned a lot from Eileen's garden this year. The summer crops are winding down, and it's now fall.
That's right, and we had some problems in the garden, but, you know, we learned a lot. Stink bugs were a problem in our garden. They affected the tomatoes, zucchinis, and we also had to help the pollination along in the zucchinis. Eileen, tell me about the watering.
Yes, if I had to do it all over again, I'd add a drip system. I had to lug this hose out every other day to water the garden. Irregular watering probably led to a lack of fruits and vegetables for some of them.
On the positive side, we learned about safe use of pesticides and how to fertilize. We were able to also cook with them and eat our garden crops.
Yeah, the tomatoes were juicy, and by freezing some of them, we could eat them well into winter. We also made some tasty pesto with our basil.
Here are the grades. Getting a C grade is chard, peppers, beans, radishes, and cucumbers.
Yeah, we didn't have big crops on those, and some barely produced at all. Maybe a lack of water, or it could have been the bugs, or maybe that the garden didn't get enough sunshine.
We did much better with the zucchini, tomatoes, and basil, all of them getting A's. They were plentiful and delicious. Overall grade for Eileen's garden, a B.
All right, so some plants were doing well and some weren't. The tomatoes still doing fine, and I've got a lot still to harvest here. We wanted to find out how much money we could recoup from what we invested in this garden box from earlier this year. The wood, the trellis, everything came to a little over $250 to put into the garden. And if we take an average vegetable price for all of the plants we harvested, or all the vegetables we harvested, we came up with about $125 worth of fruits and vegetables from this garden just this season. So if next year we plant the garden again, and already it's here, we'd recoup our money in about 2 years. So I don't think that's that bad. Again, it was quite a bit of an investment at $250 to put in the garden box, but worth it in the end. Hey, if you want to visit Pauline Sakai up in Placer County, the Master Gardeners are going to be at the Auburn Home and Garden Show this weekend.